up, guys? So today I'm going to be exploring a few different locations, the first of which is the Scovill Loop Trail. This is in Maromas. So I'm going to be exploring the abandoned valley line, which the southern part of is used by the Essex Steam Train. And there's a northern section that's used by the Providence and Worcester Railroad, PNW. But there's a stretch that is used by no one. It just sits there. Now, it is maintained, as in, like, it's cut back and there's no branches, like, covering the tracks, or no trees growing through it like there was in Cedar Hill. But it can't handle train service, at least in the state it's in right now. So I'm going to be checking out a few different locations. This trail is the first one. So yeah, let me start.
Okay, so guys, like I said, I'm starting out on the Scovill Loop Trail. I've never hiked this before, so we'll see. I don't know exactly what we're going to find. I know there's the tracks are down along the water, along the Connecticut River, so we'll find those. I believe there might even be a railroad bridge, like a small one, but I don't know, so we'll have to find out together. But yeah, so this is the Scovill Loop Trail in Maromas. Okay, so down there we have some kind of little, I don't know if it's like a marsh or what it is, but if you notice on the other side, it's hard to see on the camera, that tree line there, how perfectly straight it is, I believe that's actually a land bridge. It was made for the track. And you can't really see them from up here, but the tracks are right down there, along that flat, straight area. So I believe that was like where they basically built a bridge and then filled in the land. And then eventually the land just kind of was the land, and now it took that shape. Now, way off on the other side, if you see the water, that's the Connecticut River.
And we have arrived at the tracks, and there, right there, is a bridge, which is what I was hoping we'd find. So we'll definitely crawl down there, see what we can see. But yeah, so the tracks run along there and in the other direction. So I'm gonna walk down there and we'll get a closer look. And we've arrived at the tracks. So that's looking south, down the tracks. And now if I turn, that's north. You can see the bridge is right there. We'll definitely go explore that. But let's look at these ties. Now, I think that's part of the reason it probably can't be used. And if you look at these, most of that's gone. You can see they're all pretty rotted and falling apart. Now, I'm really interested in this rail. It's very different than, like, modern rail. Like, when I'm in Wallingford, you can see the tracks when I'm waiting for trains and stuff. And it's, I don't know how to describe it, but it's definitely differently shaped. So that makes me wonder how old this is. I assume it's pretty old, so I would like to try to find a date. We'll see if we can do that, but this is really cool. Another thing I noticed, though, is you can see there's not much ballast. It's all dirt. Like, this isn't really... A modern railroad has... It's all gravel. There's none of this dirt, none of this stuff, which is another reason. I mean, I'm sure they'd have to get rid of a lot of this and then put down ballast, and I'm not sure how easy that would be to do if they were to try to make this into a modern railroad. You can see the track is starting to crack here. I mean, it's not in bad shape, but something like that, or there's more down here. Or here, there's even a piece missing. If you can see, the whole edge is gone. So like a piece of rail like this would have to be replaced. And it kind of makes me wonder, you can see more down there, if maybe they'd have to do all the rail, which would be expensive and a big project. Okay, so here you're looking south. If you look down the rail, I have the phone right on the rail, you can see it's not very straight. Modern rail, like, it curves. This almost has kinks to do that turn. And we'll walk down that and see that turn a little better in a bit. But you can see it's rough. Yeah, see, like this tie, you can see it's hollow in there. And there's nothing to it. Okay, so here's the bridge. Now here's that middle. Every railroad bridge I've ever seen has this. It's like a rail in the middle. I don't know what it does, but you can see they had that even back when this was built. Now, I'm not positive, but I believe this was double tracked at one time. So here we're actually approaching the actual bridge. I'm gonna try to go down the side and see what we can get for a view. Oh, that's cool. You see, I mean, that looks honestly pretty strong. The fact that it's as old as it is. Now, I'm not sure how old it is, but maybe there's a date on it. Let me look. Now you can see how bad the shape is when you can hear I'm just kicking the tie and you can hear it all moving, which it really shouldn't be. So that proves that that's pretty bad off. But still, I mean, being as old as it is, it's pretty cool.
Here, the plate where that connects basically the rail to the tie, this, and has the spike go through it, the whole thing's moved, which, oh wow, I can move it by hand. So see, that shows that it's not in great shape. I'm kind of fixing it, but you can see the spikes are coming up. There's better examples on the other side. Let me go look at those. Now, like I said earlier, they do try to have some upkeep to this. I mean, if you look at all this is all cut wood. This didn't just fall this way. So that means this tree, or this branch, I'm not sure what it is. There's the rest of the tree over there. It fell across the track. So somebody, and I believe it's the Friends of the Valley Railroad, are the ones who maintain this, came and cut all this up and cleared the tracks. So that proves that they haven't just let this go. They do want to keep it at least to a point where it's passable and it's able to be fixed possibly in the future. Here's another problem spot. I mean, if you look at the connection between these two rails, first of all, this one's missing chunks. This one's in some rough shape. But then you can see it's not at all lined up. And they've all moved, which I don't know how that happens. I guess over time, maybe with erosion. But obviously, this, you gotta fix this. And so I think a lot, if not all of the rail would probably have to be replaced, along with a lot of the ties, which would be a big job. So I don't know if this will be used again. Now this tie is so far gone that the piece that the spike should go through that keeps these together is gone completely. I mean, I can't even see it. I don't know what this spike is going into. I think just the ground. So I don't know how, I don't know, maybe someone took that, but I don't know why they put the spike back in, but I don't see the metal piece around here. So I'm not sure, but you can see this is all pieces of the tie. Another chunk here. So again, here's another look at the bridge. It's hard to tell from here, but if you look really closely, see how the track like goes down and comes back up? It's like the ground, it looks like, I can't get over there, but it almost looks like the ties and the ground have kind of washed away. And so there's just rail there. And if you look further down, you can see it's not touching the tie in places. Over there, it does look rougher. Oh yeah, so look right here. I didn't notice this before, but look, there's no spikes there, and there's more, no right there. So you can see it's not even touching those ties, which are the base of the bridge, basically. And you can see further on, they start to be spiked in again. But that's a problem. I mean, that's gotta be fixed, because if not, the rail can flex, and that's when things start to break, and that's how derailments happen. Okay, so here's one more shot. I'm standing between the two rails right now, just looking at the bridge. It's pretty cool, and I'm glad it's still here, and I'm glad it's something I can come down here and check out. I think it would need some work, but I do think it could be restored. I know the Valley Railroad, which does the Essex steam train and those excursion trains out of Essex, they've started the northernmost part of their operating track. Used to be Goodspeed Station, or a little past it, right by the swing bridge in East Haddam. But I believe they've extended it now another 2 or 3 miles. So I think they are trying to renovate parts of the track, but I know there's another bridge that's bigger than this that's in pretty bad shape down there. So I don't know if they're just trying to get it to go a little further, because replacing a bridge is a big project. So I'm not sure if things like this bridge here are what's stopping them from being able to get this line running. Yeah, so here's a view of it from the trail, which is a little higher up. It is through the trees, but you can see it's actually pretty long. It's at least 25 feet long. So I'm starting to walk around this corner, and
like I was saying earlier, like it has kinks, it's not smooth. You can kind of see that from this angle, how it's like it turns and then it's almost straight and then it turns again instead of a smooth curve. Now I know new rail is very flexible and that's why they can make the turns they can. Well, maybe with older rail, this is how they had to do it. They did small sections and kind of turned when they meet two sections together. The straight section seems to be in really good shape. I mean, if you look at it, it looks smooth. I'm not seeing any of those situations where part of the rail is breaking off. So I don't know if this is newer rail or what, but I think a section like this might be okay. I noticed this white rock. That's spray painted. That's not natural. So that's probably some kind of marker. Because I know they do maintain it, so maybe that's something they marked for work or something, but just thought I'd say that. No way. I think we came to another bridge. If you look down there, it's got the thing in the center of the track, like all railroad bridges have, so let's go check that one out. I was not expecting this one. Yeah, so here's another bridge. The trail goes right there, so the trail doesn't go across it, but this one's got no water under it, so I'm thinking I might go under it and see if I can get shots from the other side. Let me get a little closer. This is cool. Now, this one's in rough shape. You can see a lot of the beams are missing, especially on this side. The whole piece that goes along the side is a whole chunk gone. So that's pretty bad. This whole bridge, actually the stone structure might be fine, but all this wood would probably have to be redone. So you can see here more, this is the pieces that are missing. It's all just rotted away over time. That's what happens when it gets weathered and stuff, and it's not used, it's not maintained, so it just falls apart eventually. So here's the view from the underside. It looks pretty good up until that end that I'm looking at right now. I mean, most of this side actually looks pretty fine. I'll walk underneath it so we can see some of the metal. Oh, that's pretty cool. You see kind of the truss design with those pieces going across diagonally. And then looking straight from the bottom, a lot of that wood almost looks new because it looks like it's in good shape. So that whole end seems fine. But then you go over here and actually most of it's okay. And it gets a little messy down that end. But that might be fixable. I mean, if you just kind of redid that end, you might still be able to use the rest of this, and that might be fixable. So there's a close-up, some of the boards. Right about there, they get fine. And I noticed they're the smaller ones over here, and I think it's because they have the stone under them that they can be, and the metal beam starts there. And this is just a piece of probably at least 8x8, probably 10x10. So I think it's stronger in the center. And then maybe that end was redone, I'm not sure. But this section, it's probably not that big a deal to fix. I don't know. So I went underneath and I'm on the other side now. This is not what I was expecting. You can see here, the whole tie is missing. I think that's what's lying right there. But I don't know why they took it out. There's the metal plate that would have gone on that. There's the other one on the other side. I'm not sure what happened though. Maybe they took it out, but I'm not sure why.
So like I said, the trail did go to the right back there. And because I don't trespass or anything, I'm not going to go any further along on this hike. But like I said, there's other locations I'm going to drive up to further down the line, further south. But this is as far south as I'm going to hike. Just because if there's no trail, I'm not really supposed to be here as far as I know. If I could, I'd love to hike this whole track. But I'm not sure of the legality of it, so I don't want to push it, and I don't want to trespass. So this is as far south as I'm going to go along this hike. But I'm also planning on later going to the former Higginham Station site and Haddam Meadows as a cool. It was a crossing, and to get in there, you have to cross it. So we'll check out both of those spots later. So this is untrain related, but this, I just got down to the water. This is the Connecticut River. This is absolutely beautiful, and I thought I had to share this.
So here's one last look from down below. I was just down there looking on the river. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's amazing. It was so calm and peaceful. A boat just came through, so now it's a little less calm, but This is an awesome spot. I definitely want to try to come back here at some point.